Hey guys, I'm Miss Gamble.
And I'm Miss Janolis.
And we are here today to read to you an awesome book called Exemplary Evidence, Scientists and Their Data. Scientists ponder, question, and wonder about all kinds of subjects, from flowers to thunder. But no matter what the query's about, a scientist's job is to figure it out. How do scientists find out what is true? They need to have data, and lots of it too. Data can be tallies, measurements, numbers, or notes and sketches of amazing wonders. You can gather data through experimentation, a process that can lead to much calculation. So measurements must be precisely taken. When it comes to data, you can't be mistaken. How far did that travel? How fast did that go? Answering these questions gives data, you know. Timers and rulers, balances and more. Data is collected with tools galore.
Afterward, there's just one thing to do. Analyze the data to find something new. By comparing, graphing, looking for trends, what will it tell? Well, that depends. No matter the data, there's just one aim. Gather enough to make a strong claim. Data is evidence for what's thought to be true. It is the foundation of what scientists do. The importance of data is shown rather well by the work of scientists too many to tell. Throughout all of history, data has been key in the making of every great discovery.
Okay, guys, so as you hear these next few stories about different scientists, I want you to be listening for how they actually use their data. Al-Hazan lived in Egypt 1,000 years ago, yet still is important for what he did show. A groundbreaking study not hard to understand. Investigations need not always be grand. Into a darkened room, 2 lanterns shone light, each of them hung from a different height. On the far wall, 2 bright spots could be seen, each of them formed by a lantern's strong beam. If he covered a lantern, the spot became dark. This simple finding ignited a spark. Light did not come from our eyes as believed. Instead, it came from a source he perceived. Al-Hazan went on to more complex topics and even wrote 7 books about optics. He is remembered as his method was clear. He was the first to use data to support his idea. The power to show that an idea is untrue. It's amazing what collecting data can do.
Maria Marion's data took another form. In fact, her life and work fell well outside the norm. During her life, she painted insects of all kinds, traveling far away to see what she could find. Not much was known about insects or how they grew. Where did they come from? The answer no one knew. Some popular ideas included mud, air, or rain. Exactly how this happened, no one could explain. Marion kept caterpillars. She watched them grow and change, even though to others, her studies seemed quite strange. Through her colorful paintings, she could document stages of a life cycle and what those changes meant. Marion's work was remarkably complete, to show how detail was really quite a feat. This precision helped other people see the lives of insects, from butterflies to bees. The power to develop a new point of view, it's amazing what recording data can do.
In the 1800s, new elements were found. These discoveries seemed to be all around. Chemist Dmitri Mendeleev had a gut feeling that organizing their data would be quite revealing. Up on cards, he wrote each one's or information and then tried his hand at organization. After many hours, he fell asleep at his desk, but when he awoke, he knew what to do next. He arranged the elements in order by weight and knew he was on to something quite great. Chemistry was changed by this development, Mendeleev's periodic table of elements. The table wasn't just a success on its own, it predicted elements before they were known. It also pointed out some errors in weight. Fortunately, the records could now be set straight. The power to predict something entirely new. It's amazing what organizing data can do.
In Havana, Cuba, the situation was dire. Deadly yellow fever was spreading like fire. Outbreaks occurred time and again. If only doctors could predict where and when. Carlos Juan Finlay was up to the task. As a family doctor, he just had to ask. His patients' histories provided him clues. The data was easy to collect and use. He looked for patterns, and with good reason. Most outbreaks occurred in the same season. From his data, he inferred the link. Mosquitoes spread the disease in a blink. Sadly, his ideas weren't accepted for years. The mosquito hypothesis fell on deaf ears. Finley persisted until others agreed that mosquito prevention was a definite need. The power to stop diseases and prevent them too. It's amazing what comparing data can do.
Nettie Stevens studied mealworms in great detail to find out what made them male and female. By using a microscope to observe DNA, she collected data we still use today. Peering through her microscope, Dr. Stevens saw two different chromosomes, one short, the other tall. Male mealworms consisted of one of each kind. Females had two tall ones, a surprising find. It was the chromosomes, Dr. Stevens did declare. The sex of the larva was determined by the pair. Two of the same meant girl mealworms would be seen. One of each, boy mealworms, determined by their genes. This work was the first to link chromosomes to traits. Her clear observations would set the books straight. All along, data hidden from the naked eye showed females are XX and males are XY. The power to understand what's out of view. It's amazing what sharing data can do.
Dr. Ruby Hyrose, a chemist, had a brilliant mind. Her data was of a quite different kind. She conducted experiments on blood and cells, collecting data to help keep us well. She suffered from an allergy known as hay fever and studied ways to improve a reliever. Adding a new substance to make it work well was a discovery of which others could tell. She contributed to other studies too. A vaccine was the goal for the work she'd do. To prevent a disease called infantile paralysis, her data would need some careful analysis. Dr. Hyro's work did not go unseen, such important studies being anything but routine. At a meeting of chemists of great acclaim, she was one of 10 women mentioned by name. The power to improve lives through and through, it's amazing what interpreting data will do.
Down deep in the ocean at the bottom of the sea, Marie Tharp wondered what there might be. Very few scientists cared about that, for they assumed it was boring and flat. No one could travel there, she had to concede, so how could they get the data they'd need? Sonar was used, a great innovation, to measure the depth of underwater locations. She couldn't go to sea. She stayed on dry land, plotting out thousands of soundings by hand. Tedious work, but she and her partner pressed on, consulting the data for what should be drawn. Mountain ranges and valleys began to take shape. It was an entire underwater landscape. The map she created of the whole ocean floor was used to prove others' theories and more. The power to change our current worldview. It's amazing what visualizing data can do.
Our human bodies are quite complex. Their intricate workings can often perplex. Dr. Marie Daly advanced our understanding. Her work and findings were truly outstanding. At first, she studied the process of digestion, but then moved on to a more pressing question. What caused heart attacks, she wanted to know. The answer, she hoped, her data would show. Dr. Daly analyzed data from many a patient and finally came up with an explanation. Many with high cholesterol had suffered an attack. Their arteries, it seemed, were clogged with plaque. This wasn't the only conclusion she would draw. The effects of cigarettes, something else that she saw. By connecting smoking with lung disease, Dr. Daly saved lives, thanks to her expertise. The power to build knowledge and improve health too. It's amazing what analyzing data will do.
In places where coal, silver, and oil are found, these precious resources are under the ground. How do you know this when you can't see? By using data to predict where they'll be. A geologist in Montana can make such a claim. Dr. Russell Stands Over Bull is his full name. Born and raised a proud member of the Crow Nation, his expertise lies in mapping resource locations. Finding these deposits was joy without measure. To him, it was hunting for deep buried treasure. Without the right data, it'd be difficult to know exactly where a well or mine needed to go. He wanted to do more to help his hometown, so he founded a company in that small town. Its purpose to help other tribes understand how to develop resources on their own land. The power to find resources and help others too. It's amazing what mapping data will do.
Scientists use diverse methods to explore, doing their work on land, sea, and shore. Despite all their efforts, at the end of the day, without the right data, there's not much to say. Jon Snow used data to stop a deadly disease, and Gregor Mendel got lots of data from peas. Data helped Vera Rubin make a strong case for the existence of dark matter throughout outer space. Data supports conclusions. It can change people's minds. It is used to build theories that help humankind. Scientists all along have known this to be true. Data is powerful. Now, what will yours do?
Hey guys, thanks so much for joining us for the reading of this book, Exemplary Evidence, Scientists and Their Data. I know that Ms. Janolis and I learned a lot as we were reading through it, and hope that you did too, and that you will continue to be curious, to ask questions, and to collect data to explore your questions. See you later.
Bye.